Thank you. Bonjour, Montreal. Thank you very much. right. Thank you. Thank you all. It's a real thrill to be here. I'm going to do some jazz, some rock, some talk, and have some fun. I got some real special guests. A couple of years ago, I was in London. I went to Covent Garden, which is like a great outdoor market there at the old railway station. And way in the back was a booth called a heraldry booth. And it's where they look up your family crest. And it's not like the ones here they have in the American Mall where they do it in a computer and then they give you this little piece of copper with a flag on or something. There, we went to this old guy with lots of white hair and little spectacles and a big white beard. And he was this old Welsh British guy. And he had all these Bibles, which had all family history, and from Denmark and Sweden and Norway and Germany. And my family tree was Bachmann with two N's. So I went back to him and I said, "Do you have B-A-C-H-M-A-N-N? And he looked it up and he found this cool thing. And he said, "So how do you say your name Bachmann now?" And I said, "No, I say Bachmann. I'm Canadian. I say Bachmann." And I'm there with my daughters, and he's getting this family crest on. So this old guy says to me, "You mean as in Bachmann Turner Overdrive?" And I go, "Yeah." And my daughters go, "Yeah, Dad, right on, yeah." So I said, "Wow, I'm amazed that you know my name. I'm Canadian. You're like, you're a British guy and stuff." And he said, "Oh, yeah, I know. You ain't seen nothing yet. And I can't wait to tell my kids that I've met you, and that's totally dead cool." And I said, "What?" He said, "That's dead cool." I said, "Well, I'm going to write a song today. I'm going to write a song called Dead Cool." It means the ultimate cool thing. So this is from Jazz Thing One, and it's called Dead Cool. Everything I've ever known is disappearing. I got to dance to the beat, the drums I'm hearing. Sometimes you gotta break the rules. Sometimes you gotta break the rules. You gotta give it all you got. It's time for winning. Take the promise of the past and send it spinning. You can make it last, cause it's only the beginning. No matter where you go, no matter what you do, walk the walk, talk the talk, and be dead cool. When you're hot, and you can be dead cool. You can be dead cool. There's something else I gotta do, but I can't remember. Maybe it will change my life if I surrender. Dreams are gasoline to fuel the burning embers. Sometimes you gotta break the rules. Yes, sometimes you gotta make new rules. You gotta give it all you got. It's time for winning. Take the promise of the past, yeah, and stand spinning. You can make it last, cause it's only the beginning. No matter where you go, no matter what you do, walk the walk, talk the talk. I gotta do, but I can't remember. Maybe it will change my life if I surrender. Dreams are gasoline to fuel the burning embers. Sometimes you gotta break the rules. Yeah, sometimes you gotta make new rules. You gotta give it all you got. It's time for winning. Take the promise of the past
Send a spin and you can make it last, cause it's only the beginning. No matter where you go, no matter what you do, walk the walk, talk the talk, and be dead cool in your heart, and you can be dead cool. You can be dead cool. What a wonderful night for a moon dance. But I'm so dead cool. You can be dead cool. Never know how much I love you. I never know how much I care. When you put your arms around me, you can sing along. I get a feeling that's hard to bear. You give me fever when you kiss me, fever when you hold me tight. Fever in the morning and fever all through. Roxanne, you don't have to wear that dress tonight. Roxanne, show your body tonight. You can be dead cool. You can be dead cool. You can be dead cool. You can be dead cool.
Thank you. Wow. Nice crowd. Thank you. You know, you have a great club here. I know we're near the end of this, but you have an absolutely great city. You know, I'm a Winnipeg kid who lives on the West Coast. This has got to be the greatest city in Canada. Honestly. This festival is the best in the world. This whole week here, with all kinds of great music, you're all so very lucky. Whether you're from here or just came here, I'll be coming here a lot because it's just a great time of year. And so congratulations to you all, and thanks to the Montreal Jazz Festival for fulfilling a dream of mine to actually come and be part of this. Yeah. So this is the late 60s. It's like San Francisco. I'm with the early guests who were just starting to write our songs, Burton Cummings and I. And we go to Berkeley, California, San Francisco, where the University of Southern California is, and this is like the peace movement going on. So I go down there to see, you know, real hippies, you know, with long hair and peace signs on their chest, and they're singing Make Love, Not War. This is like the whole Vietnam War era. And I buy a bunch of vinyl. Do you remember vinyl? Oh, yeah. We all remember vinyl, yeah. So I'm taking all this vinyl, you know, remember bootlegs? It's like, I bought a bunch of Neil Young kind of bootlegs and Bob Dylan things. I'm taking them all to my car. They're too heavy to carry around. So as I get off this street, off Telegraph Avenue, I'm walking to my car. And down the street towards me are coming three guys in black leather jackets, and they're big-looking guys. They look like a biker gang, you know, to me. I'm all alone. So when you're a Canadian, you're told way, way back, this is like in the 60s, never get in a fight with an American because they're all drafted at 18. They're taught hand-to-hand combat, right? And we're only good on skates with a hockey stick on ice, right? Canadians can fight on the ice. Right, so I'm walking down the street. This is like the Wild West, you know, when the gunfighter comes to town. All the people run into the stores off the main street. Well, these three guys are walking down the street towards me, and the people are going over to the sides and into the stores, and, like, they're looking at me. And so I think, well, I'll go look in a window, and maybe they'll walk by me, like a pretend I'm window shopping. So I go there, looking in the window, and in the reflection, I can see they've come to my side of the sidewalk, and they're getting closer and closer. So I think, I'm going to change sides of the street. So nonchalantly, without running, I whistle and I walk across and I go to look in window shop in this window, and I see in the reflection they've now come to this side of the street, and they're getting closer and closer. And it's in my head, never get in a fight with an American, but these are big guys and they're looking at me and they're going to get me. So they get really close, but from here to the front row, I mean, and a little brown car pulls up and the bumper's hanging off, the window's smashed and held together with tape and everything. And this little woman about 5 feet tall gets out and starts yelling at these guys. So suddenly, in my mind, they're not a gang anymore. There's like three guys, and this woman is like reducing them. Two of them leave. They go away, and they leave this one guy there who's obviously the man in her life. And she starts yelling at him. And 2 minutes before, he was Mr. Macho, giving me this glaring look because he's with his buddies, and now he's looking kind of like this. And she's saying, "You're nothing but a no-good bum. You left me at home with the kids. You're supposed to be out looking for a job. You're hanging out with your buddies. You didn't take out the garbage when you left," you know, all those things. "Get in that car." And he sheepishly looks at me. He gets in the car. She slams the door, and she says, "Furthermore, baby, when you get home, you ain't getting no sugar tonight." So I went and wrote this song. Lonely feeling deep inside. Find a corner where I can hide. Silent footsteps crowding me. Sudden darkness, but I can see. No sugar tonight in my coffee. No sugar tonight in my tea. No sugar to stand beside me. No sugar to run with me. Run do do down, da do down. Run do do down, da do down. Da do do down, da do down. Da do down, down. And since this being the jazz festival, I'll play you the new grown-up jazzy version of the rest of the song. In the silence of my mind, quiet movements where I can find. She's grabbing for me with her eyes, and now I'm falling from her skies. No sugar tonight in my coffee. Sugar tonight in my tea. No sugar to stand beside me. No sugar to run with me. Da do do da do da da. Da do do da do da da. Da do do da 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 da. Da do 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 da. No sugar tonight. Gestrin, piano. No sugar tonight in my coffee. No sugar tonight in my tea. No sugar to stand beside me. No sugar to run with me. You can sing. Da do do da da do da. Da do do da da do da. Da do do da da do da. Sugar tonight. No sugar tonight.
Woo!
Hey, thank you. We've got some special guests here tonight, and would you please give a warm welcome to Denise McCann.
Thank you.
And those of you who listen to our radio show, Vinyl Tap, she's kind of the lady behind me there and does the show together.
I'm the fact checker. I'd be like, no, wrong.
So I'm going to, here's a story how I wrote this song. I was in Regina. I was with a Guess Who. We had a night off, and we went to a club and saw Joni Mitchell for the first time. I saw a lady there, and I asked her for a date, and I went to pick her up the next day. At her appointed time, you guys will know this story already, she wasn't ready. So I'm waiting and waiting and waiting, and she wasn't ready, and I'm waiting and waiting. And in this room was a big couch to sit on, and a piano, and a big a tree and a plant pot kind of thing. And I grew up in Winnipeg playing violin before I played guitar as a teenager. And so when you're five, you start to play violin, you get a little half-sized violin. It's a cute little thing. And that was when I got to be seven, my younger brother under me, who was then five, got a little accordion. And even though these were half-sized instruments, he had a hard time pumping the accordion this way. So I used to get him to lay down and pull it this way. And I'd sit on his knees and yell, pump, and he'd pump. And I learned to play in the key of C, which is a magical key on piano. You can just, everything's evenly spaced, and I'm pretty good on piano in the key of C. So with this formal training in the key of C on an accordion, I sat down at a piano and I played a couple of chords that were very simple, but they stayed with me. And I was waiting for this woman to come. She's now 40 minutes late, and I'm composing a song there in the living room. And I wanted to call the song "These Arms." Long to hold you know, that kind of thing. So a little while later, I'm sitting down with Burton Cummings, who's the great keyboard player, you know, grade 12 classical piano. And I say, I got this little thing on piano I want to show you. And I showed him the beginning. He said, wow, that's so simple. I never would have thought of that beginning. And what do you want to call it? And I said, "These Arms." And he said, no, I don't want to call it that. Let's make that the second and third line, and let's call it "These Eyes." So here's a bit of "These Eyes."
Thank you. These eyes are crying. These eyes have seen a lot of love, but they're never gonna see another one like I have with you. These eyes are crying. These eyes have seen a lot of love, but they're never gonna see another one like I have with you. These eyes are crying. These eyes have seen a lot of love, but they're never gonna see another one like I have with you. These eyes.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Well, I grew up in Winnipeg. That was the home of the Guess Who and Backwinter and Overdrive. And the great thing about Winnipeg is it's the middle of Canada, the middle of the North American continent, and the middle of nowhere. You've got to drive everywhere. So, I mean, it was nothing for us. We had a station wagon that we drove into the ground, then a truck, and then a bus. And we would drive all the way to Toronto, come all the way to Montreal and play one or two gigs and drive all the way back home because we couldn't afford a hotel or a motel. We just lived in this car. So one of our legendary drives, I'm jammed with BTO, we're jammed in a station wagon, and we're driving from Winnipeg down to Mardi Gras, New Orleans to play Mardi Gras. And it's kind of rainy out and splashy and splishy on the highway, and we're driving along in our little station wagon, and a semi-trailer truck pulls in front of us. And then a semi-trailer truck pulls up behind us, and another one pulls up beside us. We're boxed in, and they're talking on their CB radios, and they decide to play games with the guys with Manitoba license plates and go 30 miles an hour. They're stuck in this little box, and we can't get out, so we're honking the horn. They'd leave a little gap, and we would try to get out, and they'd close the gap. We'd give them the universal hand signal out the window. You know what that is? And they would go 20 miles an hour. And this is getting very... So after about an hour, this is very frustrating. One of the truck drivers breaks from this pattern. He takes an exit to a truck stop, and we needed gasoline in our tank, so we took a truck stop. So this is in BTO. I'm a real big guy. Fred Turner's a real big guy. We're going to go have a word with this trucker about, you know, keeping us boxed in and delaying our trip. So truckers are pretty big guys. When this truck stopped and this guy got out of his truck, he looked like a refrigerator with a head on top. This guy was big. So we weren't as aggressive as we felt like being, and we said, "Excuse me, sir. The way you were driving there is, like, you know, really unsafe, and, like, we're trying to get to Mardi Gras and stuff." And he said, "Well, you Canadians are such polite drivers. We're just having a little fun with you. You know, you guys are all the same. You're such safe drivers." We said, "No, no, it was, like, really, really dangerous because we're trying to get out, and it's rainy and slippery." And he said, "You know, it's no big deal. Why don't you just let it ride?" So I went to New Orleans and wrote this song. And the bus driver was like a little bit, I think he was from Jamaica. You can see the morning, but I can see the light. While you've been out running, I've been waiting half the night. Try, 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 and let it ride. And would you cry if I told you that I'm not? Would you say goodbye, or would you let it ride? Would you cry if I told you that I'm not? And would you say goodbye, or would you let it ride? My life is not complete, I never see a smile.
Try, 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 let it ride.
Baby, you want the forgiving kind, but that's just not my style.
Try, 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 let it ride.
Would you cry if I told you that I lied? And would you say goodbye? Would you let it ride? Let it ride.
worthwhile, and I've been booking time.
Cha-cha-cha, let it ride.
Oh, baby, you won't be forgiving kind, but that's just not my style.
Want a bit more of that?
You can see the morning, but I can see the light.
Cha-cha-cha, let it ride.
While you've been out running, I've been waiting half the night.
Cha-cha-cha, let it ride.
And would you cry if I told you down the line? And would you say goodbye? Or would you let it ride?
Thank you very much. All right. We are back. I mentioned I have a new album out, Jazz Thing 2, and it's with a bunch of guys called the New Guitar Summit, who are Jay Giles on guitars, Jerry Beaudoin, and Duke Robillard. So here's a song from Jazz Thing 2 that Duke played on. Exactly Like You.
Thank you. gesturing.
Know why I've been true. I pray each night for someone exactly like you. Why should we spend money on a show or two? No one does that love thing exactly like you. You make me feel so grand. I wanna give the world to you. You make me understand. Every little dream I dream and scheme I scheme. And now I know why Mama taught me to be true. She meant me for someone exactly like you. Give the world to you. You make me understand. Every little dream I dream and scheme I scheme. And now I know why Mother taught me to be true. Yeah. She meant me for someone exactly like you. Yeah, she meant me for someone exactly like you. Baby, I've been someone exactly like you, like you.
All right, thank you. We're bringing back, thank you very much. Bringing back, oh, are we doing another song? Oh, yeah, we are. Yeah, Anything But Work. Another Duke song. All right.
This is a tune that was originally recorded by Ray Charles back when he was influenced by Nat King Cole before his soul and blues days. And it's called I'll Do Anything But Work.
I'll take you strolling down Lover's Lane. Come to see you even in the rain. I'll do anything for you but work. I'll sing your prayers, hold your hand, tell the world that I think you're grand. I'll do anything for you but work. Now I'll take you out to dine and dance, fill your ears with sweet romance. I know I ain't good looking, baby, what the heck. I'm all yours if you pay the check. I'm yours to have, yours to hold. But that word work just leaves me cold. I'll do anything for you but work. Thank you. dangerous with sweet romance. Oh, I'm so good looking, it's a shame, baby. And I'm all yours if you pay the check. I'm yours to have, yours to hold. But that word work leaves me cold. I'll do anything for you. I'll do anything for you. I'll do anything for you but work.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Thank you very much. Now we're going to bring back Miss Denise McCann and do a song she sang the first night I met her, which is at the Commodore Ballroom in Vancouver some 25 years ago. And I thought Aretha Franklin was on stage.
Isn't that nice? What you want, baby, I got it. What you need, I got that too. All I'm asking is for a little respect from you, baby. Just a little bit. I need a little bit of respect, yeah. Ain't gonna do you wrong, baby, 'cause I don't want to, no. All I want you to do for me, baby, is give me just a little bit of your respect. Maybe one or two other things, but I need some respect from you, baby. is work. So is my money. And all I want you to do for me is whip it to me one time. Just a little bit of respect is what I need. R-E-S-P-E-C-T, find out what it means to me. R-E-S-P-E-C-T.
Keep going, Miss Denise McCann.
Everybody's crying mercy, but they don't know the meaning of the word. It's a bad luck situation. Every day just gets a little worse. Politicians say they want justice. As soon as they do business first, toe to toe, watch them go. Take a pick and choose your hypocrite. Watch them go, toe to toe. Give a cheer and choose your souvenir. Spin doctors keep talking in circles. They don't know what they're headed for. President says there'll be peace on earth as soon as he wins this war. Thank you.
Miss Chester.
Watch him go. Give a cheer and pick your souvenir. Straight ahead, just knock him dead. This is it, just choose your hypocrite. Spin doctors keep talking in circles. Don't know what they're headed for. President says there'll be peace on earth as soon as he wins this war. As soon as he wins this war. And we're wondering what we're fighting for. Just as soon as we win this war. Thank you. Thank you very much. Whew. That was a Mose Allison tune. And written in the 60s, and it's still, like, it's pretty happening today. And that's on the Jazz Thing 2 album. And now Duke is going to take you on a trip back in time. We're going to go from 2007 to 97 to 87 to 67. This song ends up in Psychedelia, San Francisco. It's a great track called This Dream, and I heard it on his album. I said, you got to play this with us at the festival. It's called This Dream. You want to talk about it, Duke? Who wrote this?
This is written by Al Basil, who is a friend of mine, a cornet player, singer, and songwriter, and we write a lot of tunes together. And this is one of his, This Dream.
Was a wanderer who never found a home, wondering if I'd have to spend the rest of my life alone. Then you came and turned my world, and I never knew. Don't change it, this dream. Don't change it, this dream still coming true. You know you move me, baby, and you move like no one else. You know what I'm thinking sometimes before I know myself. You've seen every bad thing about me, but you never said we're through. Don't change it, this dream still coming true. Don't change it, this dream still coming true. Maybe my time was due. All I know is you so much more than I thought I had coming to me. And when my work gets hard, I can always find a way. Knowing you'll be waiting there at the end of a bitter day. You're the only reason why I feel the way I do. Don't change it, this dream still coming true. Don't change. Good luck. much more than I thought I had coming to me. You know you make my world such a warm place to be. You know you make it so much easier to be me. Now I only hope to spend the rest of my time with you. Don't change it, this dream still coming true. Don't change it, this dream still coming true. It's still coming true. Still coming true, baby.
Duke Robillard.
Thank you.
And the psychedelic experience. Thank you. Wait, are we in tune after all that, like, is that like Neil Young and Crazy Horse, like, or what, right?
The short version.
Was so strong. And as I still walk on, I think of the things we've done together while our hearts were young. I'm walking in the rain, tears fall, and I feel the pain, wishing you were here by me to end this misery. And I wonder, I wonder why she ran away, and I wonder where she will stay. My little runaway, run, 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 run away. My little runaway, run, 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 run away.
Jester.
That was so strong. As I still walk on, I think of the things we've done together while our hearts were young.
I'm walking in the rain, tears fall, and I feel the pain, wishing you were here by me to end this misery. And I wonder, why she ran away, and I wonder where she will stay. My little runaway, run, 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 run away. My little runaway, run, 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 run away.
Thank you.
from me. Run away from me. Run away from me,
uh-huh. My little runaway.
Run away from me. Run away from me. Run away from me,
uh-huh. My little runaway.
Run away from me. Run away from me.
Little runaway.
Run away from me,
uh-huh. My little runaway.
Run away from me. Run away.
Thank you very much. It's been so great to be at the Montreal Jazz Festival. Thank you, really. Whoa. Thank you. Whoa, our last, wow. Well, for the band, Roger on drums, Mick on bass, Chris on keyboards, Duke on guitar, Denise on vocals, me on guitar.
Randy on guitar.
Wherever you go, whatever you do, take care of business.
Pushing people, shoving at the girls who try to look pretty.
And if your train's on time,
you can get to work by nine. And start your slave and job and get your pay. If you ever get annoyed, look at me, I'm self-employed. I love the work and nothing all day.
And I've been taking care of business every day. Taking care of business every way. We've been taking care of business.
It's all mine.
Taking care of business.
Working overtime workout.
Here's the easiest vision. You can be a musician. If you can mix sound, start a mellow. Get a second-hand guitar. Chances are you go. The right bunch of fellows. People see you having fun, just lying in the sun. Tell them that you like it this way.
In no way.
It's the work that we avoid, and we're all self-employed. We love to work and nothing all day. And we've been taking care of business every day.
Taking care of business
every way. We've been taking care of business.
It's all mine.
Taking care of business.
This is working overtime.
Taking care of business.
One more time, we've been taking care of business.
We will take a bow. Thank you. Merci beaucoup.